Thank you so much, Pete. The anti-Trump resistance reaching a fever pitch in Hollywood. Actor Seth Rogen proudly claiming that he rejected House Speaker Paul Ryan's request for a photo in front of the speaker's children. The actor, Peter Fonda, posting that obscene tweet involving kidnapping President Trump's son, Barron, that resulted in the Secret Service being notified, and then the actor apologizing. Why do these celebrities go so low? Here to discuss this is the former Home Improvement star, actor and producer, Zachery Bryan. Zachery, thank you so much for being with us.
Happy to be with you. Thank you, Ainsley.
You're welcome. How do you classify yourselves when it comes to politics? Conservative or liberal?
I'm very much more on the conservative side. I almost consider myself kind of conservative libertarian.
Okay, so when you see what Hollywood is doing, how does it make you feel, and why are they so off the rails?
Yeah, it's really disappointing. I think Seth is a really funny guy. I think he's his own brand. It's his prerogative. But at the same token, you know, he's obviously not very solution focused. He had this opportunity to have some dialogue with Paul Ryan, maybe express his disagreements, maybe influence him on some level, and maybe they could have worked together to help, you know, help the problems that he has. But instead, he draws the line in the sand. He kind of upsets the two sons, and then he goes on Stephen Colbert and brags about it. So I don't know if there's any progress being made there.
Yeah, this is what he tweeted. He said, "Oh man, now my TL is going to be filled with virtue signaling snowflakes who are offended by my free speech." I mean, you're right. He does have the right to say, "I don't want to take a picture with you." But what's the harm in taking a picture, even if you disagree with them politically?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, one thing that I was taught by my mother and father growing up, and especially being in the public eye, is that it is your fans that make you who you are. Mm-hmm. Without them, you really are nobody, and you're not making the money you're making. You don't have the fame you have. So, again, it's drawing the line in the sand. It's separating half of this country that probably now might not want to support him in his endeavors as he moves forward.
Yeah, never forget from where you came. They're putting food on his table. He needs to remember that. Kathy Griffin, she's back, ma'am, in the news. She tweeted out a picture with Stormy Daniels, and she wrote, "I support you 100%, hashtag F the F word, Trump." Both of them are shooting the bird. We're fuzzing that out in that picture. Then she also tweeted out, "F you, Melania. You know damn well your husband can end this immediately, you feckless, complicit piece of blank." I mean, that is hateful. Why such extreme rhetoric?
Yeah, it's just vulgar. You know, this is a sign that they're losing. This is a sign, you know, I've been saying this for a while now, but they have no message. If your message is hate Trump, you're really not getting very far, with your agenda and what you're trying to accomplish.
Yeah, and where's the tolerance?
There is no tolerance. That's what I've been saying for so long.
If they disagree.
I mean, the party of
There's only tolerance if they agree with them.
The party of tolerance is only tolerant if you agree with them. Exactly. And you either fall in line or get out of line, basically. It's very much a one-way street. You know, it's kind of coming from a lot of your elitists and then their little minions that kind of just do whatever they say, in my opinion. And it's very frustrating. I feel like, you know, on the right, we have a lot more free thinkers. We even disagree with each other at times. One thing I will give the left and liberals is that, they stick to the agenda. You saw it with Bernie Sanders. I mean, when we saw that... That they basically, you know, corrupted his campaign and weren't letting him move forward. I mean, you know, they mm-hmm. stuck together. You would have thought Bernie Sanders would have gotten really upset and turned on Hillary, but instead he fell in line. This is kind of how they work, and they do stick together, but they don't have a message, and we do. We're denuclearizing the Korean Peninsula. We're going for fair trade. We're trying to make this country great again, and I'm behind it 100%.
Zachery, I know it's tough to talk about that and to support the administration in Hollywood, so we appreciate you coming on, and you have every right to have your beliefs as well. So thank you. Have a great day.
Well, I appreciate it, Ainsley. Have a great day, likewise.
Thank you.